Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I have to admit that we never expect to participate in such a workshop that is organized in the memory of Maria, especially due to the fact that we lost Maria in such a young age. The first time that I acquainted with Maria was back in 1993 through an email ad that I seen in the University of Athens for an open position for a PhD in the University of Sark. At that time, I had just completed my MSc from the University of Dundee in the UK, and I was looking for doing a PhD either in Greece or abroad again. So I took the opportunity to pursue the PhD scholarship that Maria was offering, and doing the PhD in the University of Sari, having actually two supervisors, Maria Petru and Professor Kittler. When I personally met Maria, I immediately understood how supportive she was, both at a professional and personal level, especially to the Greek students. It was not by coincidence that at that time in the University of Sari there were five Greek people doing PhD under her supervision. I did a PhD at that time in mixed pixel classification with remote sensing, trying to assess the degree of the regeneration of vegetation after forest fires. We had three very productive years working together, where I had the opportunity to see how systematic, very hard working, and motivating she was. She didn't spare credit when you did something good, and she didn't have any issue to share mistakes, because this also happened. Especially when you start working in a research field. So we had what I believe was a very good collaboration in those years. And immediately when I conclude my PhD thesis with her, she offered me the opportunity to co-write with her her book, the book that we had together, the Image Processing the Fundamentals, that was based on her idea after her experience with teaching in image processing courses. So we had the opportunity to continue working closely for three more years, even from distance, because at that time I relocated to Greece, but we had a constant interaction. And Nicole spending many evenings in her house working either on the thesis in the beginning and later on the book together. If I want to use one of the favorite expressions of Maria, what was the take home message after working with her was that hard work always pays off. Maria was very focused on her research, but also she was very proud of herself. So she used to tell me to get on and have a family of my own, which it took me a little bit longer to do. And now, being a mother of two, I have to admit that that advice was completely right. She also helped me to find my first job when I came in Greece. She introduced me to Hellenic aerospace industry, and my first employment was working on a scientific project for EUMETSAT, doing geometric correction for the METOSAT second generation, which actually is currently in operation. And then shortly after that, I moved to a different which is the international company of ODE. And the last 7 years, I'm held in the position of the CTO of Otello. A long time has passed since the first mail that I sent from Maria back in 1993, where mail and internet was not a commodity as it is now. I recall having to read that through cyber, for those of you that are old enough to remember. And currently, the situation changed a lot in the telecom business. Internet is a reality for all of us. And if I'm allowed just to I don't do a lot of research in the image processing, as you understand, so I won't present anything hugely technical. The only thing that I would like to know. So, a little bit about what is the ODE Group. ODE is the incumbent telecom incumbent operator in Greece with affiliates in the Balkan region. And ODE Globe is very active in the voice business and in data business, exchanging more than 3 billion minutes internationally per year. A lot active in voice over IP, and also a lot active in data business, being carrying more than 75% of the Greek telecom traffic and 35% of neighboring traffic. This is the network that we have. It's a network. There are four routes interconnecting Greece to Western Europe, two of them going through the Balkan region and two others through Italy, reaching London. Greece is also very well interconnected to neighboring countries, very good partnership with Turkish operators. We carry one third of the Turkish traffic. Due to the geography, we are along the path. Let me stay a little bit on that. We are very active with collaboration and partnership with the Middle East region and Southern Africa region. We participate in international submarine consortia. Interconnected. Here you see with the yellow line the footprint of CMB3 cable reaching Australia. We recently invested 40 million to a new cable connecting Hong Kong to Marseille, landing in Hania. And we believe that we can interconnect everyone and we can provide the dumb pipes for the images to be broadcasted everywhere. With good quality. I don't want to spend more of your time. I didn't want to focus a lot on the research, even though there was a period in my life that the research was very important. It has been quite some time now that my job is more administrative and I'm a user of somebody else's technology. And I didn't want to drag along all stories. What I would say is that the passion of Maria and the focus were something that I tried to follow in my life, and I believe that it helped me a lot in my career, especially due to the fact that being a woman in a manly world, it was a little bit harder for me to succeed, because I felt that currently I managed to achieve most of my goals. Another thank you from me to Maria to her contribution to my life.